Every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of lights. James 1:17. Take no purse with you, no haversack, no sandals. Salute no one on the road. Luke 10:4. When Jesus sent his disciples out to evangelize, he commanded them to take no gold or silver. They were put all their trust in divine providence. God takes great care and provides all their needs if they completely trust Him. On the seventh day of Novena, preparing ourselves to celebrate our Mother Founder's Day, called to reflect upon trust in Divine Providence. Divine Providence is God's extraordinary intervention in the life of people.
I don't know about I just live from day to day. I don't borrow from its sunshine, for its skies may turn to gray. I don't worry o'er the future, for I know and today I'll walk beside Him, for He knows what is ahead. Oh, many things about tomorrow I don't seem to understand, but I know
without providence of God, it would be hard to reconcile sickness, famine, violence, natural disasters, injustice and suffering and any other hard facts of life. When God seems to have abandoned us, nothing seems to make sense. It takes a certain level of spiritual maturity and intimacy with God to surrender to divine providence. That nothing happens without His permissive will. God's divine providence can reassure us in our decisions and remind us that we are not in control. The more we accept and trust in divine providence, the more the Lord will manifest His goodness and wisdom. Jesus tells us, "Are not two sparrows sold for a small coin, yet not one of them falls to the ground without your Father's knowledge. Even all the hairs of your head are counted. So do not be afraid. You are worth more than many sparrows." Matthew 10:29-31. St. Paul tells us, "We know that all things work for good for those who love God, who are called according to His purpose." Romans 8:28. God causes the parting of the Red Sea and the changing of the water into wine at Cana, God using the miraculous power to accomplish His purposes. The Lord has His way in the whirlwind and in the storm, and the clouds are the dust of His feet. Nahum 1:3.
God often uses the wrath of men for His design. Joseph, being sold into bondage by his brothers, is an example of God's providential working. Although Joseph's brothers sought to get rid of him, God promoted him to the palace, and he became the second highest in command in all of Egypt. As Joseph remarked to his brothers, "You plot evil against me, but God meant it unto good, to bring to pass, as it is this day, to save much people alive." Genesis 50:20. He was reconciled with his family. This is exactly what Jesus did for us. This is probably the greatest example of divine providence. Jesus suffered through agony and torture, carrying the full weight of our sin, giving his life to save many, that all the people of the earth might know the hand of the Lord. Joshua 4:24. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. The creed has not finished revealing to us its extraordinary riches linked to the revelation of divine providence. God is in control of everything. We see an example of divine providence and human free will in the early life of Saint Paul. As a Jewish religious leader, Saul led the persecution of the early church, but later understood that he had set himself against God's will. Acts 26:14. The reality of evil deeds does not weaken God's providence. It actually strengthens it. The two verses from sacred scripture says, why one can trust God's plan. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. Jeremiah 29:11. No one has ever seen, no one has ever heard, no one has ever imagined what God has prepared for those who love Him. 1 Corinthians 2:9. God's plan for you is not limited to the number of years we live on this earth. God's providence involves you spending your eternity with Him, where you see and experience the fullness of God's presence and the fullness of His joy. This is the destiny that God has prepared for you, and He will carefully watch over it until it comes to pass.
Be not dismayed, whatever betide, God will take care of you.
We need His wings of love abide. God will take care of you.
God will take care of you through every day or all the way.
Jesus asks for childlike abandonment to the providence of our Heavenly Father. Therefore, do not be anxious, saying, what shall we eat or what shall we drink? Your Heavenly Father knows that you need them all. But seek first His kingdom and His righteousness, and all these things shall be yours as well.
Reverend Mother Claudine Eschenier quotes, whatever happens, I shall not be worried. I have a Father in heaven who will never fail me. There is a secure refuge for those who would wish to take shelter in the wounds of our Divine Savior. They can toss us about, but they cannot upset us. In all that happens to me, I see the disposition of divine providence. Thus, I am at rest always. These lines express perfectly her attitude of total trust in the divine providence of God.
Oh,
from the book Family Annals. It was the harvesting season. The dark clouds announced bad weather. For the crops, the parish priest gave permission to harvest the wheat. Since it was Sunday, Mother kept praying till midnight. At the midnight, she went to the fields to see the crop. She found it dry and ready to be taken in. At the first hour of Monday, she called all the personnel of the farm, made them pray and sent them to work. The work was finished towards 8 in the morning. The rain began to fall. Great was the surprise to know that everything was gathered in. The people said, "The sisters have nothing to worry about because Mother Claudine makes the good God give the weather she wants." What God wants of us is that we should live each day as it comes, like a bird in the trees, without worrying about tomorrow. Although sometimes we are faced with impossible decisions or unsure about our future, we can rest assured in a God. Prayer. Dear Father, we leave everything to you. We know that you will provide us with everything at the time, in the place, and in the manner best suited. Do with us what you will. Whatever you do, we thank you. We are ready for all and we accept all. Let only your will be done in us. We wish no more than this, O Lord. Into your hands we commend our soul. Father, lead us on our way to that happiness and peace of mind for which we are destined in this life, as a foretaste of the everlasting happiness we have been promised. Amen.